Well, let's see if this is working. Testing, checking sound, checking video, making sure we have everything. Looks like everything is working. Okay, looks like everything's working. Can someone let me know if the sound is working? If there's anybody watching yet, let's see. Can someone tell me in the chat if the sound is working? Just trying to make sure everything is working here. Looks like everything is working. Well, I want to welcome everyone to my first YouTube live stream. I purchased these Azure Professional Artist markers last week, and I've been wanting to do some stuff with markers, and so I saw these in the store and decided to get these and try them out and to test them out and see if we like them and see how they work and see how good the colors are and how good the markers are and just kind of do a review of the markers as well as, you know, kind of test them out on some paper and draw some things, just different things, and just test these out, and we'll just try these out. And then as be sure and in the comments do the hashtag imagination arts so that I will see your comments and questions, as well as let me know if there's any issues with the live stream, as this is my first time doing a YouTube stream. I've done a Facebook stream once before, but I've never done a YouTube stream yet. So this is my first try on doing a YouTube stream. And so if, as you're going along, just let me know how things are going. We're going to first start off. We'll go ahead and get into it. We're going to be using this Canson Mixed Media paper and these Azure markers. And again, as I said, these, I purchased these at Walmart in the art supply section. Is there's a set of 13, and they are professional artist markers, premium quality alcohol based markers with dual tips and fast drying. And so let's just open these up. Pull these out. Side. And this is what they look like, and it says they have red, orange, yellow, green, or I should say light green, or green 1, green 6, blue 10, blue 12, violet 16, red 10, it comes with brown 5 and brown 11 and black. And then this is a blender. This gray one is a blending marker here. And then again, this is red 9 and orange 4 and yellow 11. So those are the colors. As again, it says it's a set of 13. Just thought we would get these. I saw these in the store. I've been wanting to get some markers and try to do some things with markers. Again, it's the set, the Azure set of 13 at Walmart is where I purchased these. So I'm just going to, first of all, turn to a page in my book. Find me a good page here. Okay, here we go. And we'll just see. First, I thought we'd just kind of start off with just doing some swatches to see how these lay out. And again, there's the wide tip. And here is the small tip. You can see the small tip. The colors look to be pretty bright. And they go on smooth. Again, like I said, they are pretty bright, so they do look like these might. Again, since they're fast drying, it's probably going to not blend as well. That's probably why they have the Azure blender over there that comes with, so that you can blend it. Just do some quick swatches just to see how the colors look. And if y'all have any questions or anything that you want, or something that you want me to do with these markers so that you can see how they do with that, be sure and put that in the comments in the chat. Here's the darker green. And again, the fine tips are usually used for doing details. Darker red. And then after we get these swatches done, we'll do some blending with them and see how they blend. Now I just want to do these swatches to get these colors on here so we can see how they're going to work. Okay, and this is the blending one. Again, it has a fine tip as well as a full tip. Okay, now that we've got that done, let's do a little blending. Down here in the corner, let's do blue and yellow. So we'll lay down our yellow. And then we'll put some blue down on top of that. And I'm going to go with the lighter blue, let's see. Okay, and then we're going to take our blending tool. Let's see how we get the nose. Nice blue and yellow blended together. Now let's do two colors going from a lighter to a darker and see how we do.
Incoming call. I put it on screen. There is a call for you. Do you wish to ignore? This call might be important.
The blender seems to do some pretty good blending. As you can see, okay, let's try doing. Do that, and we'll just go. Blend that and see how that looks. Keep opening the wrong end. There's some general things that we can get a picture of how these would work. So now that we've got a general idea of how these would work, let's go ahead and do, and as you can see, they do bleed through. So, and this is mixed media paper. It's not real thick, but depending on how heavy you put it down, they do come out, they will bleed through. So now let's go to a fresh page and use the back of this. And we're just going to see what different types of effects we can get out of these marker tips. So let's do some lettering. Try using the tip. Let's try doing the side. You can kind of get an idea as to some of the different effects. Let's try turning it this way. I'm going to turn over to another page. Okay, so. It's just kind of this kind of gives us an idea of some of the different effects that we can get from these marker tips. There we have that. And if we turn it to the side, we could do this with it. Using the tip, we could get it via a finer line. That's the bottom of it. And then with the fine point we got this just to use a very tip, but to use it just really lightly, you get a really fine point, a really fine line. Okay, so and as you can see, I was using a really light hand with these and they still bled through. But the lighter that I got, the less they bled. So if you use a heavy hand with them and you put it on heavy, they will bleed through. So now let's try doing a piece. Let me get a pencil out here. Okay. Let's see. Let's try to find something to draw. I'm trying to think of something I could try. Let's just do. Plotted plan. Okay, so we're going to do... Then we're going to erase these lines. A little design on here, so we'll do this. Some shadow over here. this mirror on. Let's put some dirt. And then we'll go and let's go ahead and do this carpet. Let's paint the carpet of the floor. Let's make it light. Okay, now let's put some shadow down. And I'm going to use the dark red for my shadow. Let's start working on our plant. We're going to make this a aloe vera plant. Remember, we want to use a light hand with this, and you don't want to go with over the same spot too many times or it'll start bleeding through. We want to keep as we found out with our swatches earlier, we want to keep a light hand and not go too heavy. Okay, now that we got that, now we can start putting in some details. And before I start putting in detail work on here, I want to kind of blend some of this out and lighten it up. Okay. I've got that kind of lined up, so now let's start putting some details in. Darken those up a little bit. Okay, we got that in there. I was kind of filling that background. Let's go with light blue. Okay, I'm not going to fill in the whole background, but there's a pretty good idea of a picture. Let's see how it did on the back. As you can see, the areas where I kind of got a little heavy-handed with them and went over the areas too many times, it bled through. So you will want to use kind of a light hand or really thick paper for this. Let's try one more thing. Let's see. I'm just going to draw a room here. Just kind of do a light sketch. Okay, let's see. Let's start with the floor. Let's start with a light brown. And try to darken it up a little. These strokes go in the same direction as the floor. See if we have any comments or questions or suggestions. No, I don't see anyone on the stream. Some detail on that floor. First, we want to darken up this area back here. Different walls.
An idiot is attempting to reach you on your cellular device. Thank you.
Okay, now we've kind of got a idea as to what these markers will do and how they will work and what the colors will look like. So I guess we will bring this live stream to a close, because we've basically done what I wanted to do with this live stream, which is just basically open up these markers and test them out, try them out, see how they would work, see if they'll bleed, see how bright the colors were, how well they blend, and we've basically gotten an idea as to, you know, how they will work and what they will do and how they will look. And so with that, if you got something from this live stream and you enjoyed this and you want to see me do some more of these, just be sure and give the video a like down below and leave me a comment on any ideas or suggestions or questions that you might have for any of the things that we went over in this video. Thank you and see you around.